Hey guys, what's up? So I'm doing a bit different of an intro. Normally my makeup's done and I'm like, this is the finished look and here we are, blah, blah. So today we're gonna do the whole thing from start to finish, blank faced. My face is moisturized, just so y'all know. But I really wanna change my shirt because it's really comfy, it's really cute. And I got a medium, it's from Target. I like baggy hoodies. I like baggy hoodies too. I like baggy sweaters for wintertime. And it's like 30 degrees outside, so yes, I'm happy about that. But super comfy. It's big. So I'm gonna zoom you guys in, and we're just gonna get started on this tutorial. Alright, you guys are up close and personal. It's really awkward, but it's cool beans. So today's look, as you can tell by the title, if I could talk, we're gonna be doing a Thanksgiving makeup look, which is next week. Oh my, so fast. Like, Christmas is almost here, and I'm not ready for all this nonsense yet. Like, I am not ready. Not at all. My skin's looking hella good. So, there's that. Someone at work was like, you look different, and I didn't want to be like, well, my acne's gone. I didn't want to say that. So I just was like, I don't know what you're noticing, but I'm glad something looks different. Oh boy. So, as per usual, I'm going to be doing my brows with my 9000 brow tools. First, I'm going to be taking the Benefit processing my brow in shade at number 3. I have to get a different shade soon, hopefully. So, quickly before like I finish my sentence, I'm redoing my hair. And this kind of plays with it as well, because I'm going to be doing a bold red lip before I change my hair. Once I change it, it's not going to look good. But I've been doing this with my hair. I'm doing it this Friday. It's like the mermaid look. I'm really excited for it. But yeah, I'm prepared for some crazy looks coming your way. So I really wanted to do this before I changed my hair color. I don't know why I'm closing my eye over here. I have the hiccups. I went to spin class this morning, guys. It's a thing in my life now. I was so sore afterwards. But it was a good sore. We went at like 9:15 this morning. And they're about an hour long. And I won't, lie. Thank you so much for putting all on my pants. That I wanted to puke to begin with. Because I am not a morning workout person. But once I got through like 15 minutes, I wasn't so bad after a while. Turned out alright. So I used a towel that has like fuzzies in it. I don't know why. Or how they got on there. I need to do my eyebrows. So I saw this thing on Ulta.com. It's online only and Michael Todd makes it, but it's a thing that like gets rid of your peach fuzz, because I shave my peach fuzz, which is so not good for your face. But I really might buy this thing, but it's like $100 and I'm trying to be really, really, really good for Christmas, and it's really, really, really hard. So that was precisely my brow. You know, I throw the bottoms of everything just like wherever and then I lose them. Gee, Val, I wonder why. So going over that with the Gimme Brow. Hold on. I'm going to be using a new foundation today. I'm really excited actually. It is the CoverGirl, what are you? True Blend, and it looks like it's my shade. I got Ivory. So, we shall see. You can hear my TV on the background. I'm gonna leave it on for my cat, the anxiety cat. I have a cat chewing on my clothes. It's It's a wonderful time in this household. Can you just stop being weird? Alright, so I'm just going to quickly set those in place, move on to priming my face, and getting on to the eyes. As per usual, I'm using my Gimme Brow by Benefit in the shade number 3. I said this in the mirror, in the camera. Would not have went well. So those bad boys are put into place. Like so. I was gonna color correct today. But I don't really feel like it. I don't feel like my skin needs it. Maybe. I'm debating. I don't really know. I haven't decided that far yet. So I'm gonna be using my usual primer, the Farsali Onion for an Essence. It is my Holy Grail foundation. I did film a favorites video, but I have to refilm it because I was still sick and I was trying to talk and I was kind of like choking on my own spit, which sounds really gross. Like, that was not cute by any means. So, there's that. I'm getting my nails redone soon because they're getting a little old. I don't know if you guys can tell. My light's so bright. But I'm gonna be doing color this time versus the white tip. And I don't know what color I wanna do. I really wanna do like an ox blood red color. Cause like it's the season time. And it's totally okay. And no one would like think I'm weird for like having a really dark color. So this is settling into my skin, making it all prime and awesomeness. I haven't worn makeup in a couple of weeks. Yeah, a couple of weeks, and it feels really weird. Since Halloween, I went from like, I don't know, I have to insert like a picture of my Halloween stuff, because at work I was like my inner child. I like pigtails and like a Disney shirt on. Kind of keep it clean at work, you know, I'm a waitress, so I have to keep it like appropriate. And then I was at my friend's house doing my makeup to go out, and it turned into like unicorn. It went from a vampire to a zombie real quick, because I had like the fake blood. It turned out okay though. It was alright. It made everything just better, I guess. I'm gonna be priming my eyelids. Eyeballs, the huge, with the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in the shade Original. This has like the no color. I'm bringing it up to my brow bone. I do a little bit on like the inner corner too, just so I get everything. Nothing's left behind. So I'd asked on here a while ago in like the comment section, or maybe I just asked in my video. I think I asked my video. Like, what you guys want to see from me? Like, do you want to see just eyes or just lips or just your face? Or do you want to see the whole thing? A lot of people actually said they want to see like the whole thing because they actually get different ideas from everybody about like what they do. And I thought that was a great thing. I don't remember who said that, but some girl did, and I was like, good to hear. Thank you for an answer. So thank you for that answer. I'm trying to incorporate more like doing the full routine as well as do some like voiceovers and do some other stuff too. I used a little bit too much powder. Oopsies. I know on camera it looks really white. I don't have that problem in person though. If it doesn't exist. I don't know.
Weird.
So for palette, I don't think I picked one out. I did. So I'm gonna be doing a glittery eye is my end result. It may not go that way though. No. I'm going to be using the Morphe 35T to create my like base, transition shades, all that. And it looks like so. It's really pretty on camera, actually. And person's kind of really dull. But this is like really pretty on camera. So I'm going to grab some brushes here. Stop crying, please. You're fine. I'm going to be grabbing clean brushes, preferably. Grab this BH Cosmetics brush, which is a concealer brush, but I can't find any of my brushes, so there's that. I'm going to grab this shade over here, looks like so. Just going to lightly, really dark color, lightly put this in to my crease, bringing it up to my brow bone. I'm going to put it on the lid just a little bit just because it's cool. Not a big deal. I wish Morphe brushes or Morphe palettes had mirrors on their palettes. Be cool. Alright, I'm gonna grab this brush. This is a no-name brush. It's really stiff though. No, I'm gonna grab this one. This is really soft too. It's fine. I'm gonna go make this a little bit darker. I'm gonna grab the shade down. Oops, sorry, down here. It's like so. I'm gonna focus this more on the outer V area. I'm gonna kind of deepen it up in there, and then with the first brush we use, which is this one right here. I'm gonna blend it out. I really like this. I'm actually gonna do one eye at a time, just so the glitter stuff has time to dry. So I'm going to carefully grab. Let's see. I'm going to grab some glitter glue. This is by Too Faced. It's called their Shadow Insurance Glitter Glue. I'm going to grab this on a flat concealer brush. I'm going to do it on this one. I don't know what this is, but we're going to put it on there. So I'm just gonna do a little bit on here. A little bit like so on there. I'm just going to put this on my inner corner here. Like the inner half of my eye. And it's getting tacky to what I want. Right before it dries, I'm gonna take my Stila, Magnificent Metals in the shade Diamond Dust. I'm going to carefully put this on my inner half. It just has the glitter glue on there. Now, I learned last time to not go up to, like, your crease. Sorry, my eye's watering. Opposite eye, I don't know why. Because it'll, like, transfer anyways. So just be really careful when doing this. I'm just going to kind of keep my eye closed for a minute. at least my not touch my crease. These do dry down pretty fast, so there should be no issue with this. Alright, it's almost dry. I just touched it. Of course I did. So I'm going to carefully grab the first brush we had been using. I'm going to lightly, like, just blend this together. Nothing crazy. So I'm gonna I think I'm gonna drag this over a bit more. No, I'm just gonna go back into the palette and I'm just going to blend this carefully together. Extremely carefully. That, and I'm from the first instant shade we used, and I'm gonna blend this all together. I'm gonna go back over the glitter and get all over my face. You guys can tell or not. I'm gonna touch it up. I've been giving like a silver color doing it. I'm gonna give it silver. I'm gonna grab this shade right here. I'm gonna go over that and see if it helps. Added the like perfect base to it, or like top coat. Perfect. So I'm just gonna finish up with this eye, and I'll be right back. All right. So both eyes are finished, like so. I'm gonna grab my makeup wipes. I'm just gonna put up the sparkles because they are everywhere. And I'll reprime my face. They really are not coming off. Alright. I'm also going to grab. My boyfriend texted me. I'll be home. Alright. Now I'm going to grab my primer, as I was saying. I'm going to reprime under my eyes here just a little bit. I'm going to grab it on my hands. Bring it this way. I really like how the eye turned out. I did the glitter before in a different tutorial, and I didn't like the way it came out. I don't know what I did wrong or differently. I just did not like it. The glitter is still there. Unfortunately, I can't get rid of it. So I'm going to grab, let's see here. What do I need? Oh, foundation. Like, what am I doing next? I'm gonna find a brush. foundation here. It's the CoverGirl True Blend. Or True Blend Liquid Makeup. I'm going to be grabbing this expert brush from Real Techniques. Someone told me also that it was a dupe for the Urban Decay Optical Blurring brush. And I don't agree. That's okay. It's an all right brush. Foundation's on there. Just going to dot this everywhere. I'm gonna start blending it in. So far the color is doing all right. And like once I blend it, it is meeting my shade. It honestly just looks like your skin, but better, kind of. It's like the bottom getting off, but I mean, it concealed my redness pretty well, for the most part. Interesting. It's not getting cakey or anything. Weird. I will say weird. I'm definitely gonna wash my brushes and try to put the Morphe brush because like that's my go-to brush when they're clean. So I'm gonna try it on that and see if that makes a difference. Maybe it's just this brush being weird. So for concealer, I'm gonna grab my NYX HD concealer. I haven't used this in a really long time, so I'm gonna use it today. Brush. Okay, moving on to setting my face. I have powder everywhere. I'm gonna grab my Morphe, I love this brush, the E41. It's a huge, huge brush. I'm just going to pat this into my skin and then swipe it away. So pat it and swipe downwards. To set my under eye, since it is such a big freaking brush, I'm gonna grab a different brush and get under there. I'm gonna grab a Morphe M530, and I'm just going to grab a little bit and pack this under here. So it looks like so. My forehead looks really flawless. That's my face, I guess. I don't know. It is oxidizing, and it's just making me kind of mad. Sad. Alright. So for some bronzer, I'm actually going to grab the Butter Bronzer by Efficient Formula. And I'm just going to grab this big fluffy brush from e.l.f. Throw this in here. I'm not gonna I'm just bronzing, I'm not like contouring or anything, so. Alright, so for some highlight, I'm gonna grab the, I'm gonna use a different one actually. I'm gonna have this e.l.f. one. It's in the shade Moonlight Pearls, and it's one of their baked highlights. I'm going to grab that Morphe M530 brush, and I'm just going to use it for my highlight. Do you not want to play today? Okay, I'm gonna grab this Luxie brush and see if this works on there. Some makeups have like a fake film on these, so until you like start using it, it doesn't come off. Pretty, if it would just freaking work. Alright, so screw that blush, brow blue highlight. I'm gonna go with my normal one. My trusty soulmate. This is the Ofra Rodeo Drive highlight. Subtle highlight. So I'm gonna grab some blush. I'm gonna use the same brush. I don't even care. I'm gonna grab blush. I'm gonna grab my Milani blush in the shade Luminoso. Looks like some. It's a really pretty pink color. And go. Red. I trust myself. Probably not the smartest thing I did. Alright, I'm gonna grab like a berry color though. Let's see here. Yeah. I'm gonna grab this shade and you know I'm probably gonna change it to this one. We're going this color. I'm gonna take the NYX lip liner in Cabaret. Pretty sure it's what it is. I'm gonna carefully line my lips. Like so. I'm gonna grab this Sephora. It's one of those oil infused coloring cares. It's in the shade Fresh Berries. Pretty sure my like patio set's blowing away on our balcony. It's really cool. So to finish off the face, I'm gonna spray my face before I finish my face though. So I'm just gonna fix my hair really quick because I do not want this to be unable to work. I'm gonna take my Morphe on Prep and Set. Like rock berry colors. I don't know if I can do that red. I don't know. This is more like a Christmassy look, I feel like, but there's berries in there, so it's more Thanksgiving. Alright, finish up the eyes, I'm gonna grab this little pencil brush, and I'm going to grab the Morphe 35T palette once more. I'm gonna grab that first transition shade that we went in with. Run this along my lower lash line. Something like that. Then grabbing that very last shade we used, I'm gonna take this and put it all over my bottom lower lash line as well. My bottom lower lash line. My lower lash line. Yeah. Doing it like that. I think falsies look amazing with this look. I'm not in the mood for falsies. Not in the mood, you know, it happens. But I'm gonna put some mascara on, do my hair, and then hopefully have date with my boyfriend. Like, I look good, I deserve date night. So I'll just quickly curl my lashes. For mascara, I'm going to be using the, let's see, apparently this one. This is the Essence Forbidden Volume Mascara. I'm also going to use the Luminous, the Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara by L'Oreal. I'm going to just pop these on and I'll be right back. So this is it for the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you are not already, please subscribe to my channel. That means the world to me. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.